What's up, everybody? It's your boy K, and I'm here for another cooking with. Nah, can't do it like this. White shirt. The hair is all messed up. I still ain't fixed this yet. The top is fine, the sides are that. Alright, well, let's fix this. I like that trick. Alright, so today we're gonna be making some meatloaf. We're gonna make a little quick lunch, we should call it. So, it's time for another edition of Cooking with K.
I do it.
So today what we're making a little quick lunch here. Making a meatloaf. Now, I get the 90% lean, whatever the F that crap means or whatever. But I thought this might not be big enough, but I think it's big enough for me because it's only gonna be for me and it's only for lunch. All right, so what you gonna need? Make sure you wash your hands before and after touching this. Put that right there in the sink. Like how I like to do it, I like to get in. So, sometimes you need two eggs, sometimes you need one. So what I'm gonna do, since it's just a small thing, I'm gonna use one egg. One egg, crack it in there like so. Take that out. Put that there in the sink. You know what? I'm gonna use two eggs. Crack that in there like so. You got your oven warming up to 450. All right, I'm gonna wash my hands again, so I'll be right back. So you got your thing in the tray like that. Give me some black pepper. Just sprinkle that in there. Don't gotta be much. Do it to your liking. Next up, some onions. I'm not a fan of a lot of onions, so what I'm gonna do is put it, I don't know if you see that, put the onions like that, do it like BAM! You know, like that. Alright, see? Oh, no, that's too much. Alright, like that. See, that's cool, just a little bit. Remember, it's just for me. The onions are for the flavoring. Now, if you don't actually like chewing the onions, we got onion powder. All right, so onion powder. You can sprinkle that on there. I never did the onion powder before thing, so this is a brand new thing for me. All right. That's just my oven telling me to hurry the hell up and put that forward. I'm gonna use some Lowry seasoning salt. All right, we're just gonna put just a little bit in there. Also for flavoring, you know. And it feels like I'm missing something. Now see, I'm at grandma's house and there's no freaking salt. Sea salt. I'll pass. I could have sworn I bought some, but it's all right. Also, what I do is with the ketchup, I take the ketchup and I just squeeze it in there. So like that. Don't put too much, don't put too little. If you put too much, it's gonna come out tasting like, it's gonna be all soggy. All right, so this is your product right there. So you got the eggs and that. Now what I like to do is you take your fingers, make sure it's clean, clean fingernails and all that, and just go ahead and mix it in. That's how my mother used to make it. She used gloves and I don't have any gloves. You don't have to use gloves if you want. See, right now, So I probably should have used one egg because right now it is kind of looking crap. But just make sure you. So if that happens, what you gotta do is just keep mixing it up. I should have just used one egg since it's just one thing. I mean, like, it's just a small thing. Usually use two eggs when it's like a big thing. But ketchup, that also will make it the mushy type crap. And I got this pan for like $2 or whatever. Had to buy another one because all my pans keep disappearing. And no, I'm not a professional cook. I don't plan on being a professional cook. That's not what I want to do in life. But you're going to be a young bachelor. Even if you're going to be a little married man, you know. You need to learn how to cook for yourself. And that was a few. Ah, yeah. All right, so it's getting into like this. Again, together. Pull that up a little bit so you see what's like that. Take it in your hand like that. So there's your stuff there. And just keep continuing to mix it up. My shirt says, fix your own light bleep bleep computer. Yeah, that was funny to me. And I just had to have it. Alright. So what I'm gonna do. What I'm gonna do is, I feel like I'm missing, this is salt right there, but you know I don't need that. What I'm gonna do is, just go ahead and mold it how you want it. Mold your meatloaf how you do it like that, so you guys can see it. All right. Just mold your meatloaf like that. It's gonna expand anyway, so. Whatever. Remember, this is just lunch. So I figure instead of spending $10 for 8 chicken wings and 2 sodas, which I would get from a Chinese restaurant, why not just spend $6 and make your own home meal? Alright? And I think it's great. Put in your pot like so. Alright, now I'm gonna step away for a minute. I'm gonna wash my hands again. You know what I'm before I do that. What I used to like to do is like just put some ketchup on the top. I know I should have got some more ketchup. No, you're not about to see me put water in this to expand this. I'm sure we got some more pepper right here. But what you can do is just go ahead and smear that on there. You know, give it a little, the top of a flavoring. All right. Don't gotta be too fancy. All right. What you can do is wipe this extra ketchup off here. So you don't got nothing burning. Put this in the middle rack. Alright, I did say it was lunch, right? So, meat, good. Now we need something to go along with it. Gordita. Gordita. And some Del Monte corn. This is some of the best corn. I love this. I used to like Green Giant, but I think I like this the best. Alright. Now I went to the local supermarket, so these were $1.29 each, where you can get them for like 89 cents at Walmart. And the big box was only how much was that? It was like probably like $3.50. So what? I figured I'd just get these because I don't eat that much in the big box, and I'll just sit in the fridge. All right, with these, Come with your little package. Yeah. We gonna need some water. So, you fill them up to the line. There's a little line. You know, I'm gonna do it one at a time. Fill it up to the line. Make sure you get all this wrapper stuff on there. Because I know last time I had put some of these in the microwave, it got some crumbs in it, be careful. And the microwave just started sparking. I think like the lid got some type of metal in it. But just, once again, fill it up to the line. I know the camera can't see that. Ah, there's a lot in there. So I'm gonna do one at a time. Pop it in the microwave. It calls for 3 minutes and 3 minutes and a half. Microwave temperatures may vary. All right. So, take a little can. They're probably like, why I'm using this big behind can for this little bit of corn. It's got a little drainer thing and I like that. All right, so we can, so you guys can see that. Where I like the simmer because the meatloaf ain't done yet. Put that on the simmer. So it's looking nice so far, so we're just gonna let this corn simmer here. Get rid of your trash. All right, we'll be right back. Ah, yeah, everybody. All right, so we're gonna take the thing out the oven now. All right, if you see the time difference, it's been more than an hour. Editing, doing production, I'm doing all that, and 30 minutes just wasn't enough. I took it out at 30 minutes, I tasted it, it wasn't that good. I left it in there for about 45 minutes to an hour, maybe more, and it tastes perfect. All right, so I'm gonna let you get that, get you look at that. It's half eaten, cause I kept opening it, and it just tasted so good. So that's your lunch. That's your lunch. Got your corn. Ta! Voila! Let's put it on the plate. First, let me give you a little view here. Look at that, look at that, look at that, look at that. Corn. Yeah, that's dry. And that's how I make my meatloaf. Look at that, that's delicious. Got your meatloaf, got your macaroni, got your corn, got me. I wanna thank you for watching, and I'm out. Peace, I'm gonna enjoy this. And remember, gotta let the meat, you gotta give the meat like an hour or 45 minutes per pound. So, the 30 minute thing, forget about that. So yeah, you got your meat, your mac, and your corn, and that's what I call lunch. I wonder what's for dinner.